Hey everyone, welcome, welcome. My name's Charlie, and today I'm going to be playing to 400 Days in Stardew Valley. If you haven't seen the first three videos of this series, you should definitely go check them out. I added some links in the description below. It has been quite a journey in this world, and this is going to be my final video on Barley Farm, which is a little sad, but I've got some big plans for this 100 days. For one, I want to collect one of every color slime egg and try to just create some cool colored slimes. It seems kind of fun. Secondly, I'd like to purchase a matching rainbow cowboy hat for my horse Nala, because I just think that'd be kind of sick. We'd be like Boolin, I don't know. In terms of perfection, I need to cook the stupid bean hot pot. It's the last recipe I have left. I also have to craft one of every recipe, ship one of every item, get Abigail to 8 hearts, and last but not least, essentially make 10 million gollars in the next 100 days. I'm legitimately starting this challenge at $300,000 because I'm an idiot and I bought the movie theater, so definitely stay tuned to see if I can pull it off and also to watch me spiral into insanity. You're not gonna wanna miss it. Alright, let's get into it. So day 301, I started things off by tending to the fish ponds and adding a sprinkler into the slime hut. You guys left a bunch of helpful comments on the last video, so thank you so much for that. I didn't even know those squares were for water. I don't even water my cat, to be honest. Afterward, I headed to Pierre's and bought a ton of fairy seeds. My big money-making strategy that I came up with was crafting a bunch of fairy dust to instantly make ancient fruit wine. So I set up some sprinklers on my Ginger Island farm and planted about 50 seeds. The next day, I got all my animal products going, filled the jars in Jam City, and then went to Skull Caverns to look for Omni Geodes to buy the rainbow hat and also purple slime eggs. The third day was my first ancient fruit harvest of the challenge, so I picked all of them up and collected all the finished wine from the quarry. I also decided to put some wine in the casks in my basement just to experiment and see how much they'd sell for at iridium quality. Then I returned to the infested Skull Caverns and basically had a panic attack for 10 minutes straight. Why are there so many of them? Oh my god, oh my god, oh my god. No, 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 why are there so many? The next morning, I set my feelings aside and gave my first gift to Abigail. You're the best? I literally tried to blow you up like a week ago. You must be concussed. After another night of just pure terror, I ended up with a bunch of gems, cloth, and some other items to chuck in the shipping bin. I got impatient and sped up one of the iridium wines to sell along with all the pickled veggies and jelly that I'd gotten from Jam City. At this point, I felt like the easiest thing to do in order to progress toward perfection was finish finding all the golden walnuts. So I cracked open these mussel rocks on the beach and headed to the Pirate's Cove for a couple games of darts. Now, I'm not gonna lie to you, I had no idea what I was doing, but it seemed like no matter where I threw the dart, it just ended up a bullseye, so after a couple minutes, I ended up with all three walnuts. I placed more slime egg making machines that night, and then sold all my food that I cooked last time, because, let's be real, I'm never gonna use any of this, and I'd rather have money. On day 306, I returned to Skull Caverns and found not one, but two purple slime eggs. I also sold a ton of ancient fruit wine and made some decent profits, but I was hoping to get a lot more from my wine business in the future. I started off the next morning by selling a ton of extra fishing lures, weapons, and armor because I was really desperate. Uga had grown into a full child overnight, so I could now yeet her, which made me really, really happy. The rest of the day was spent in the volcano mines trying to get a ginger slime egg, but with no luck. On day 309, I tossed a couple items in the shipping bin, but I still had a bunch more that I had to grind for, like the large white egg, mead, and juice, so it would be a bit before we could complete that goal. After, I brought all my extra geodes to Clint and opened up every single one of them to sell the minerals and gems inside. I figured that maybe I could get a good amount of money from them, so I essentially spent the day running back and forth between the blacksmith and the farm. Also, for some reason, I didn't realize you needed sprinklers to grow green beans, so after all this time, I finally got my beans and cooked bean hot pot. The next morning, I decided I was getting really fed up with the slimes bouncing all over the place, so I built some enclosures to trap them in, which proved to be much more difficult than I thought. After a couple in-game hours, I was able to maneuver them into separate pens, and then I found this raccoon squirrel thing and gave him some fried mushrooms. It was also around this time that I realized I needed to craft all the recipes from Mr. Chi as well, which meant I'd have to save up the Chi gems to buy them. In order to do this, I accepted the mine invasion quest and started to make my way down the floors. On day 312, I brought more food to the raccoon squirrel guy, and he straight up just turned into Totoro and flew away, so I returned to the volcano and got my first tiger slime eggs. These eggs sell for $8,000 each, but I decided I wanted to breed the green slimes and the tiger slimes to try and get white slimes and create some sort of diamond farm. Funny enough, I ended up getting a green slime egg the next day, which would allow me to begin my experiment. The next day was spent going through the mines as well as harvesting and replanting my fairy roses. I was racking up a decent amount of diamonds every day, so I decided to make some more fairy dust to expedite some of the ancient fruit wine. Although the setup for my Ginger Island farm was super inefficient, I was kind of in love with it and I really didn't want to tear it down. I liked the fact that I had any crop available to me at all times, and I thought the way it was set up was really pretty, so I decided to keep it even if it was bad for business. For the rest of the night and into the next morning, I mostly ran around Ginger Island and checked all the golden walnut locations. I ended up getting every single one, so I crafted some more items and purchased the recipe for the Desert Warp Totem. On day 318, I did something very shameful. I deforested the entirety of Ginger Island in the name of kegs. But look, it had been a month and I only had $1.4 million, and I desperately needed to increase my earnings, and wine was definitely the best way to do it. After harvesting all my artisan products and ancient fruit the next morning, I added some more kegs to Jam City, enclosed my tiger slimes in their own pen, and decided to change my mining profession. I realized that for the past month I'd been an excavator, but that as the gemologist I would make 30% more for my gems. So that was pretty frustrating. I definitely lost out on a bunch of money there. But I couldn't stay mad long because the next day was the Feast of the Winter Star, and you know, that's a time for cheer and happiness and like eggnog. I don't know, just makes me think of eggnog. I gave Elliot some crab cakes and ended up getting Alex as my secret Santa, who gifted me the tea set. Isn't this rare or something? I think it's rare. I have no clue at all, but I consume probably dangerous amounts of tea, so I found it pretty fitting and I placed it on my living room table. When did this chair get here? Oh, I also had a bit of a mental breakdown that night and sold most of my gems, so yeah, that was definitely a decision that I made. I kept chronically forgetting about Abigail's existence, but I remembered to bring her a gift the next morning and then purchased the heavy tapper recipe from Mr. Chi. I crafted some more recipes and then spent the rest of the day deforesting the entire desert. On day 322, I made a second slime incubator and returned to Skull Caverns to try and get more cloth and gems to sell for profit, and the next day was pretty much the same thing. Ooh, chest! Guys, how many of these have we gotten? 3? 4? Is this normal? This doesn't feel normal. Day 324 was the first day of spring, and I was so happy that everything was green and beautiful again, but I was also cripplingly stressed because I only had $1.6 million. So I got all my animal products going and then worked on making more kegs to place in the quarry. Also, I walked into this cutscene with Jas and Vincent, and I'm not gonna say anything that happened, but look at this picture. It is actually impossible to hold a spring onion this way. I've provided a reference photo of me trying to hold a leek like this to show that it simply does not work. At the same time though, I do have very small hands that people constantly tease me about, so maybe it's just me. After witnessing that atrocity, I headed to Ginger Island and realized that in order to get the recipe for deluxe retaining soil, I needed 50 cinder shards because I sold all mine. So the next day, I returned to the volcano and got 2 more tiger slime eggs, as well as exactly 50 cinder shards, allowing me to buy the recipe. When I got back to the farm, I realized a couple of the green slimes had hatched, so I released the tiger ones and officially started my white slime experiment to try and farm diamonds. I also got desperate again and decided to start making and selling iridium bars, because I had like 800 iridium ore, something crazy like that. I was ecstatic to find that the next morning, Uga had started crawling, even if she was getting a little close to the fire. While I was collecting slime that morning, I also noticed there was a pale-looking slime that had appeared, but I wasn't 100% sure if it was a white slime, so I just let him be. I also harvested and replanted my fairy roses again, allowing me to craft around 25 fairy dusts to make ancient fruit wine. Because I kept getting so many blue cowboy hats, I decided to convert all my sea urchins into tiny cowboys. Oh my gosh, what are you doing? I was getting pretty annoyed with my slimes just running free, so I decided to make another pen for the green slimes and tiger slimes to breed. This was much easier said than done though, and after a long time trying to get them all corralled, I decided to just give up. That afternoon, I rifled through a garbage can that reminded me of Abigail, so I headed into Pierre's to give her a tasty rock snack. What is this? Oh my god, we're actually playing together. Oh no. Maybe I can sacrifice her? No. Oh my gosh, I've never played this game. Oh god, oh no, oh no. Okay, yeah, that's my bad. Why are you not doing any of the work? You're not even shooting in the right direction. You are so bad at games. Excuse me? You're really bad. After that experience, I decided to harvest all the crops in the greenhouse and on Ginger Island just to lower my heart rate. I also spent the next day on Ginger Island hoping to get more tiger slime eggs. I was making some big bucks selling my iridium bars, but I was also starting to run out of ore, so I decided to spend day 330 in Skull Caverns to collect some iridium. It must have been a pretty lucky day because I ended up getting a ton of cloth, a prismatic shard, and some purple slime eggs which sell for $5,000 each. Because I'd been spending the past couple days mining, I had a lot of farm chores to catch up on, so I spent the next day collecting slime as well as harvesting and restocking Jam City. I ended up making a bunch of money that night, which boosted me to almost $2.5 million, which still wasn't great, but was much better than I was doing before. Now that I was starting to see some returns, I had a clear conscience while deforesting Ginger Island again because I need more kegs. In the past month, I'd done a lot of selling, so most of the items were complete, but I still had to ship kale, juice, large goat milk, mead, and a tulip. Okay, we're gonna leave some fruits here. Oh, no, we are not gonna leave any bombs here. Nuh-uh-uh. The next day, I checked up on my wine, and then I sold a bunch of artisan goods, begrudgingly gave Abigail a gift, and bought the seeds I needed from Pierre's to plant on Ginger Island. Okay guys, we need to ramp things up around here. We are getting rid of this lovely path and replacing it with ancient fruit. I don't even care anymore. We are falling behind. Yeah, this was pretty much around the time where I started to spiral into insanity. At this point, it was day 335, which meant I had 65 days left to make over $7 million. I felt like I could definitely get to 10 million, but I just really needed to start grinding and trying to be more productive. So first things first, I made a couple more kegs and added them to the quarry. Then I started smelting gold bars to sell in addition to iridium bars, and I spent the whole night filling the top part of my Ginger Island farm with ancient fruit. I decided to craft some bone meals as well as a cheap and easy way to get hypergrow, so hopefully I could start harvesting it a bit faster. I also did a bit of redecorating as well. Just wanted to keep the interior fresh and exciting, you know? I began day 336 by adding some hypergrow to the ancient fruit, and then I continued to deforest every area on the map in the name of Jam City before spending the night in Skull Caverns. At this point, I was just anxious to see some profits, so I used a bit of fairy dust on my ancient fruit wine to bring it up to iridium quality. I was also disappointed to see that after all this time, there were still no white slimes, but I couldn't be bothered too much because I was planning a secret operation for that night. Excuse me, sir, I need to borrow this. I read that if you wear a pirate hat or a deluxe pirate hat and talk to the bartender in the Pirate's Cove, he'll give you some free mead, which I can then sell to check that off my list for the perfection quest. Don't worry, I looked some pirate lingo up before doing this. All hand hoy, avast ye, batten down the hatches, you bilge-sucking booty bounties! Gosh, let's do a shanty and get a clap of thunder. Ahoy! Yeah, I think that went really well. I don't think anybody noticed. As I was going through my routine the next morning, my phone rang, which I did not know could happen. Just wanted to check up and see if Barley Farm is doing well. Good, not good. Wait. I don't think he's ever gonna call me again. After scaring the bejesus out of Lewis, the day was pretty normal. I mostly harvested fairy roses and smelted metal bars to sell, and the next day I finally reached $3 million. After harvesting some island crops, I adventured in Skull Caverns for the rest of the night. For pretty much the entirety of day 340, I literally ran around town just collecting salmon berries and trying to find Abigail. I went on the mountain, I went in Robin's house near the wizard tower, but I just could not find her anywhere. Finally, there you are! Just standing here, being creepy. Of course. I also shipped the tulip and the kale that I had grown, so when I woke up the next morning, I got the full shipment achievement. I also found this very odd cinder shard that glitched into the center of the water, and that was pretty exciting. On day 342, I crafted a couple more kegs and added those bad boys to the quarry. At this point, I think the Jam City is evolving into Wine City, and that honestly makes me very proud. Jam City walked so Wine City could run. Is this your guinea pig? What's his name? David? Why do I remember that? It'd be a shame if something were to happen to him. I continued to craft recipes the next day and also headed to Robin's to purchase the remaining brazier. What the heck? There were still no white slimes in the slime hutch, so I decided to thin out the population a little bit. I spent all of day 344 in Skull Caverns to collect iridium, and then on day 345, I accepted the Mr. Chi quest to give 50 loved gifts in a week because I really, really needed some Chi gems. And just like that, I was back to running around town like the great value Santa that I am, delivering random gifts to every person in Pelican Town for the next few days. Here, have a gift. Also, can you please stop placing random furniture in the house because it's ruining my feng shui? Oh. I feel a sensation in my body. Is this platonic love? No, I honestly think that's just me. Uga is walking! I'm so proud! Although I didn't want to, I was forced to attend the flower dance on day 347 because I needed to purchase the crafting recipe for a tub of flowers. I decided to shake things up and dance with Sam this year because he's a pretty chill dude. We like Sam. While I was running around shuttling gifts the next day, I walked into yet another cutscene with Abigail. What is this? Why is she fluting? And why am I just creepily watching? Ooh, a leak. I would like to leave now. Oh, what is that? A mini harp! Ah yes, good thing I always carry my mini harp with me. You're full of surprise. Yeah, quite frankly, I'm pretty surprised as well. After a couple days of suffering, I gave Krovis a wild horseradish, completing the quest and earning me 40 Chi Gems. This allowed me to purchase the recipe for the hopper, which meant I only had the hyper speed grow left to buy. On day 349, Wine City got a massive upgrade. I crafted a ton of kegs, and I reorganized the quarry a little bit so I could produce ancient fruit wine more efficiently. I also made another pair of Lewis's shorts, mostly because so many of you guys kept telling me to in the comments. I'm still not giving them back to him though, so I'll just place them right here. What did I do wrong? I started off the next morning by tending to the fish ponds and then restocked Wine City and started panic selling more of my expensive items. I don't need this, right? Like, I already have the Infinity Blade, I can always get more. It's fine, it's fine. I also thought that I'd created a white slime, but when I killed it, he only dropped stone, so I'm assuming that it was more of a very light gray slime. After that disappointment, I just spent the night in Skull Caverns to collect more cloth and gems. Something I forgot to mention is that for two of the crafting recipes on the list, the Quality Bobber and Solar Panels, I need to complete community projects before I can get them, so I'd been checking the board every single day. Why am I putting a pomegranate in the mayonnaise maker? Oh my god, I'm getting so stressed out. I got really lucky on day 352 and ended up getting the Juicy Bug quest, which gives you the Quality Bobber. So for the rest of the day, I went through the early floors of the mines killing bugs. Within a day, I'd gotten all the bug meat that I needed and left it in the barrel next to Willy's house, completing the quest. The next morning, I received the recipe for the bobber from Willy and... what on this good sweet earth is this? Is this the bug meat? That was in my pocket? And there's a bone in it! Bugs don't even have bones! Fitting with the theme of fishing, I also accepted the quest to catch all the relatives of the legendary fish, so I spent the rest of the day heading to each of the locations and fishing them all up. Most of them. I hate the glacier fish so much. Oh no, that seems very not good. Does this mean they won't be able to breed white slimes now? Wait, actually, these look kinda sick. Although all my slimes had been cursed, I had bigger fish to fry. Literally, why is this glacier fish so terrible?
Oh my god.
Every time, it's painful every time. I hate this fish. What on earth? Me sell good hats? Is this that little rat near the wizard tower? How does everybody get this number? Stop calling me. I decided it would be really cool to display the original legendary fish as well as the relatives, so I emptied out the fish tank in the living room. Unfortunately, I didn't have the upgraded fish tank for Mr. Chi, so I put the Son of Crimson Fish here for safekeeping until I'd saved up the gems for it. Then, I crafted the quality bobber, and the next day I purchased the recipe for Hyper Speed Grow and spent the night collecting cloth. By day 357, I was honestly starting to panic a little. I actually spent an entire real-life day taking stock of every single item I owned and calculating the money I could make if I sold all my earthly possessions. So here's my spreadsheet. I split everything up into sections. So this is the fruits and veggies and such. And then we've got the fish, the materials, and then a category just called other for everything else. So for the fruits and veggies, I counted how many of each quality I had, and then calculated how much money I'd get for just selling them outright, and then also how much money I'd get for selling them in a preserve jar or a keg. I did the same thing for the fish, and I also calculated those based on whether I had the fisher or the angler profession. Then I also calculated how much I'd make if I made all of the ore that I had into bars and sold those with the blacksmith profession versus just normally. So with everything said and done, I'd basically make a little bit over a million if I sold absolutely everything I have. So that's gonna be my backup plan if things look like they're going south a little bit, and we're gonna keep that in our back pocket. With all that disgusting math aside, I continued to chip away at all the crafting recipes, collected more slime, and had something a little odd happen. Why is sashimi a cooking option? I don't have a single fish in my inventory. Like, the closest thing would be white algae, but that's not a fish. I guess I'll just make it? I'm so confused! Oh no! Guys! This is the Crimson Fish Jr. I made him into sashimi. He was in the fridge. I decided to just place it here. The legendary sashimi, we can call it. After collecting all my finished iridium mine from the cellar, I got super lucky again and ended up getting the Island Ingredients quest, which would allow me to craft solar panels. So with that quest accepted, I spent the next couple days in the volcano mines killing tiger slimes to collect ginger. At this point, I was starting to get really stressed out because we were over halfway through and only had $4.5 million. I harvested some ancient fruit to calm myself and then continued to collect ginger for the ingredient quest, and that's pretty much all I did for the next couple days. Because my main source of revenue was ancient fruit wine, I was still making some decent money every day, even though I was mostly just hoeing up ginger. And exploding a bunch of slimes, that too. I took some time off in between ginger collections to put cheese in my casks and replant my fairy roses. But I was back to the grind on day 367, and by day 368, I'd finally finished the quest and unlocked the recipe for the solar panel. I decided to accept the Mr. Chi mine quest once again in the hopes that I'd find some rare items I could sell. In between aging my cheese, I headed to the mines and just killed all the monsters I could to try and get some rare drops. I also fixed up my farm and started to make slime eggs more consistently with the slime press, meaning I got the green, blue, and the red slime eggs fairly easily. At this point, I also realized that rushing Skull Caverns was a much better use of my time because the rare drops there, like batteries and energy tonics, sell for a bunch of money, and I hadn't really been having much luck in the regular mines. I also get purple slime eggs pretty frequently, which sell for a lot. The next day, I finally got to 8 Hearts with Abigail, which meant I never had to speak to her, ever again. Then, I took the Skull Cavern invasion quest to try and get better items. Come to my room after dark, around 8 p.m. That is the creepiest letter I've ever received. No thank you. I really ended up liking the pastel slimes that I'd created, so I decided to give up on my white slime idea for the time being. I also made a couple more kegs, opened up all my extra geodes to sell some minerals, and purchased a matching hat for Uga. Why are you guys so creepy? On day 377, I continued to do some mining and also traded my emeralds for cheese, because I realized if I aged them to iridium, I'd get more money. And yeah, for the last day of summer, I was just going full speed ahead in Wine City, and also I died. Which is kind of a ripoff, like this guy barely breathed on me, but whatever. I lost my yam! I don't actually remember what that was for. The cheese I'd put into the casks a little while ago was just starting to finish up, so I sold those and saw that Lewis had sent me $500, which I'm pretty sure this is hush money. I'd started to run out of wood again, so on day 381, I continued to deforest the town in the name of Wine City. Most of my time over the next couple days was spent mining for prismatic shards and harvesting. On day 383, I sold a bunch of my cranberries for a quick buck and then headed back to Skull Caverns, and I don't mean to flex or anything, but everybody keeps commenting saying they've never found a dinosaur egg and that I have insane luck, but like, I'm pretty sure I get at least two almost every single time I go. On this day alone, I got four. Like, I don't know why I get so many. Maybe you guys just need the burglar ring, I don't know. The grind continued for the next couple days, and by day 386, I'd reached 7 million gollars. I decided to play until the Spirit's Eve festival because I still needed the jack-o'-lantern recipe, so this meant that I had 20 days to make 3 million gollars. I was not about to fail this challenge, so I kicked everything into high gear. I'm talking ingot making, I'm talking skull cavern runs, honey collecting, deforestation, I sold weapons and armor, harvested blackberries, and continued to make more and more ancient fruit wine. I was not messing around, and I was ready to do anything it took to make that 3 million gollars, even if the means were unconventional. Like turning mussels into sashimi. It doesn't even make that much money, but I was getting extremely desperate here. Most of those things were just supplementary income, though. The real moneymaker was the ancient fruit wine, so I also continued to produce fairy dust, which would allow me to finish it instantly. I also made some extra preserve jars on my farm so that I could process all my extra fruits and veggies a lot quicker. I got so desperate, I started killing my own slimes to try and get tiger slime eggs, but I think I just killed all my favorite pastel slimes in the process. Every single day was spent squeezing as much profit as I could out of all my streams of revenue, and every single night was spent selling pretty much everything I owned. If you remember, I'd calculated that selling all my earthly possessions would give me over 1 million gollars, and I very much needed that money, so I said goodbye to all the items I'd gotten over the 400 days. We're at 8 million, only 2 million more to go, we can do this! So far, going full speed ahead was yielding good results, so I continued to just try and get as much money as I could. One good thing was that it had been thundering pretty often, which meant I could sell the batteries for $500 each. Generally, the storms produce around 10 to 15 batteries too, so that in itself is a pretty solid source of money. Also, I read that past level 120 in the mines, the chance of enemies dropping prismatic shards dramatically increases, so I gathered all my stone and started planning a trip deep into the mines. I didn't want to go until I had an extremely lucky day, so for the next couple days, I just did some normal caving and made even more kegs for ancient fruit wine. As it was, I was consistently getting over $150,000 a night, so there was still a really good chance of reaching 10 million. It would just be really, really tight. But with the amount of gems and slime eggs that I was getting, I was pretty confident that if I just grinded nonstop for the last week, I could do it. Okay, this is getting ridiculous. Can somebody actually tell me what the odds are of getting this hat, like, what, 5 times now? Oh my god! On day 399, I decided to take the leap and started to staircase my way past level 120. I made it all the way to floor 127, but I only ended up getting 2 prismatic shards, so it ended up being kind of a bust. That's okay though, because the next day I added more furnaces to make ingots and harvested all of Wine City, raking in a total of 165 bottles of ancient fruit wine. That's absolutely nuts. I'd also stopped selling my ingots because I realized it would be a lot more profitable to hold on to them and then ship them once I'd changed my profession to the blacksmith. That meant that I'd be getting 50% more money for the metal bars. Oh my god, that's insane. That is so much money, we can actually do it! By day 401, we'd reached 9 million gollars, so with 5 days left, we only had 1 more million to get. I was actually getting legitimately stressed out, so I decided to take the day to just open up some geodes and sell minerals. I also gave all 50 of my cowboy hats to the sea urchins because I felt like it was much more fitting than the other hats they'd been wearing. The next day, I continued to grind and spent pretty much the entire day repeatedly smelting gold bars and instantly making ancient fruit wine with the fairy dust. On day 403, I harvested and sold all my Ginger Island crops because I knew that at this point I didn't have the time to put them in preserve jars. 9.6 million with 2 days left was pretty close, but I was pretty confident we had it in the bag. The next day was nothing but chores. I collected batteries, made a bunch more furnaces, sold the rest of my possessions, and went to the spooky sewer dog to change my profession that night. And so, with nothing left to my name, I grabbed my 400 metal bars and headed over to Clint's. Oh my gosh, we did it! I could have gotten this so much sooner. I have so many bars left. I was so relieved, I can't even describe it in words. I purchased the gold clock and immediately started to add some decorations to make it look nice. I'd also kind of let the rest of the farm decay because I was just so stressed out, so I decided to slow it down and just spend the rest of the day doing repairs. I also added some more lights to the farm, and then on day 407, I purchased the recipe for the jack-o'-lantern and also the furniture catalog. Before I crafted the jack-o'-lantern and reached full perfection, I wanted to decorate the area with my golden clock. I ended up adding some benches and furniture trees. I put mahogany trees in between them, but they didn't grow fast enough. I actually got the inspiration for this from my aquarium video because I was super happy with how that turned out, and I thought it would frame the clock really nicely and add a little bit more life to the farm. Then, on the morning of day 408, I completed the last crafting recipe, and nothing happened. Oh god, did I mess something up? I'm at 100%! Oh my god. I was so scared that I missed something. I'm so happy. You feel it in your heart somewhere, somehow, Grandpa's beaming with pride. The legacy of Barley Farm is eternal. Oh my god, why am I getting emotional? I've never actually reached perfection before. Whoa! Is this the way to the summit? Wow, I did it. Why are the trees glitching out? And who is this? Is that Morris? Oh my god. No. Charlie, my favorite JoJo member. What? This sucks! This feels so bad. I don't support you. I just didn't have time to collect bundle items. This feels so wrong. Oh my god, that's my husband. So I did it. I reached perfection and I accomplished all the things that I wanted to on my farm. I met the love of my life, had two kids, made over $10 million, befriended everyone in the town, and yet, somehow, it doesn't feel like enough. As much as I find Lewis fun to bully, it didn't feel right that he wasn't the one waiting for me at the top of the mountain. Like, this isn't even a bit, I feel legitimately guilty. I feel like I've been wanting to do a perfection run, but instead of becoming a slave to capitalism, I'll complete the community center instead. If you'd be interested in watching that, let me know, and also let me know if you like the format of the 100 days videos, or if you'd maybe want to watch it more as like weekly episodes. So less of a challenge video and more of a gradual grind, I guess. Thank you guys so much for sticking around with me for all 400-ish days of this journey. I've had so much fun in this world, and I genuinely appreciate all your love and support. If you enjoyed the video, feel free to leave a like or subscribe to the channel. I'd absolutely love to have you here. And with that, I'll be signing off of Barley Farm for the last time. I'll see you guys next time. Bye! Arr! Ahoy me hearties! Batten down the hatches, you bilge-sucking, buccaneers, you little buckos. You son of a biscuit eater!